What's going on, you guys? Keith Carnes here, and welcome back to the channel. More of the traditional content is coming back here. I just have not really been up to doing the face-to-face stuff. Just a lot of stuff going on in my life. I've been very busy on the weekends and whatnot. Just been doing a bunch of different stuff, but I don't want to bore you with that because you're probably not a subscriber anyway and you're just stopping by. So today we are reviewing Mountain Dew Black Label Dew with Crafted Dark Berry flavor with other natural flavors. There it is right there, Mountain Dew Black Berry. It has already been drank, but I guarantee you I drank this entire thing. The nutrition facts, it's 210 calories per serving. Serving size is a can, so 210 calories, which sadly is not the worst thing you can actually get, especially from a Mountain Dew product. My overall thought about this whole thing was that it was going to be like their Kickstart stuff, and I don't like the Kickstarts. I think I've reviewed one, maybe two of them on my channel in the past. I can't be 100% sure how many. I think one. And I didn't like it. They lacked flavor, they just weren't that good, and they were very disappointing for a Mountain Dew product. I'm really into Mountain Dew. You guys should know I'm a huge Mountain Dew fan. Though, oddly and kind of funnily enough, I'm not actually really big on Mountain Dew's normal, regular flavor, but Code Red is one of my favorite sodas out there, even though I don't need to be drinking soda and I actually am giving it up. However, Mountain Dew Black Label Crafted Dark Berry is actually, it's pretty good. It's not amazing. I actually watched a review before I decided to go out and try this on it from a channel I watch, and they gave it a really, really good review. Me personally, I don't feel that it really deserved that level of praise. It just didn't do it for me that much. It was good. Would I get this again? Probably not. They're kind of on the expensive side. Here you have what I'm drinking now. Another very unhealthy beverage is a Rockstar. They're the same size and everything, but the Rockstar, you can actually find Rockstars cheaper than you can find this. This thing cost I bought this for $1.89, whereas I can get a Rockstar for $1.50. So my overall opinion on it is it's okay. Some people are going to like it more than I liked it. I thought it was good. I just don't think the flavor was as powerful as it should have been, but I'm just used to strong drinks like Rockstars and Mountain Dew flavors like, you know, Voltage, Code Red, etc. So I just didn't feel that it really clicked with my taste per se, but it's not a bad beverage by any stretch of the imagination. It is good. If you're like a person that likes kind of dark berry stuff like myself, I recommend it, I guess, but I like dark berry stuff too. I just didn't think the flavor was as powerful as it should have been, and I don't think that the price is justifiable by any means. I mean, if it was $1.50 and it was equal to the price of a Rockstar, I could live with that, but the fact that this at Safeway here in actually, at least here in California, is $1.99, and I got it at a gas station for $1.89. So I think that the price needs to definitely come down a little bit because it's just not, I just don't see what's really justifying that. So from a 1 to 5, 1 being it's horrible, to 5 being it's the best thing I've ever tasted, I would definitely give this thing a solid 3. I'd probably put it in the middle of the road a little bit. It's an average beverage. It's nothing to write home about. It's nothing that I'll ever really care to drink again. It's just average. It's just like, it is what it is. And here you go. So I hope you guys enjoyed this beverage review. This is Keith Carnes, and I will see you guys in the next.